The Korean War was a product of the tension between the United States and the Soviet Union after the Second World War. America's foreign policy on the containment of communism extended overseas. Both nations had differences on their perspective of the role of government and resulted in North Korea siding with the communists while South Korea combined forces with 16 other democratic nations. The South Koreans were taken by surprise as North Korea tried to unify the Korean Peninsula under communist rule. Without a sufficient amount of artillery that was required for the South to gain victory, their goals of establishing a dictator-free nation was shattered, and the communists were able to invade South Korea with ease. The North Korean troops coordinated an attack at several strategic points along the 38th parallel on June 25, 1950, heading south towards Seoul. The South sensed despair as they saw their capital fall into the communists' hands.
The grief did not last very long because the UN decided to take a firm stand. Due to the belief of a domino theory in which communism would fall and spread to countries through the initiation of the Marxist idealism in the Soviet Union, the US sent UN troops to assist the South Koreans in their war. The arrival of the UN troops greatly boosted the South, giving hope and strength to push the North Korean and Chinese troops back. Eventually, losing most of the South territories, the South Koreans fled to Nakdong River near Busan, where North Koreans were finally halted for the first time and lost their chance of almost winning the war. The troops arrived continuously from both sides as the constant warfare depleted both sides' army. With more soldiers, General MacArthur of the UN Army led the South Korean and the UN Armed Forces to Incheon, a major source of supply for the North. With the UN's successful victory in Wolmido, the UN was able to land their troops on Incheon beach grounds and cut the North's supply. With the North's major supply source gone and the assist from the UN, the South greatly benefited and had a chance in winning the war. With the victory in Incheon, the South and UN pushed to gain Seoul back to make the North retreat back to the 38th parallel line. The South Korean troops were alone as they marched forth the 38th parallel line as UN troops were left behind. By now, the South was high in their morale and took courage in marching through the communist territory.
Unfortunately, Seoul fell under communist rule as the unexpected Chinese soldiers suddenly invaded and scattered both the UN and South Korean troops back to their territory. The South's morale dropped and even retreating was difficult at this point. The North's advancing troops caused great decrease in their supplies and food, which would cause them to retreat back to the 38th parallel line. By now, the UN military learned of the Chinese strategies in battle and attacked the Iron Curtain, which connected the three cities that the Chinese soldiers were located. Breaking the Iron Curtain, UN and the South decided for a peace negotiation with the communists, which instantly failed due to their difference in territorial gains. Korean War dragged on for two more years, and the U.S. wanting to end the war led to bombing of the North's hydroelectric plants. This did not end the war. Just as President Dwight Eisenhower was elected to presidency, he declared a nuclear threat to the North, which caused the Chinese wanting the peace negotiations. Papers were signed, and long struggle between the divided lands of Korea was over. The South had its democratic government and the North formed its communistic government. The Korean War obstructed communism from spreading to the South, but the North and South is still divided along the 38th parallel line.
He said, "Son, have you seen the world? Well, what would you say if I said that you could? Just carry this gun, you'll even get paid." I said, "That sounds pretty good." Black leather boots, spit shine so bright. They cut off my hair, but it looks alright. We marched and we sang, we all became friends as we learned how to fight. A hero of war, yeah, that's what I'll be. And when I come home, they'll be damn proud of me. 'cause it's a flag that I love and a flag that I trust. I kicked in the door, I yelled my commands. The children, they cried, but I got my man. We took him away, a bag over his face, from his family and his friends. They took off his clothes, they pissed in his hands. I told them to stop, but then I joined in. We beat him with guns and batons, not just once, but again and again. A hero of war, yeah, that's what I'll be. And when I come home, they'll be damn proud of me. I'll carry this flag to the grave.
My name is Lee Tae-ri. 1940년 1월 15일생인데 그때 당시에 내 나이가 10살이었어요. 근데 하루아침에 갑자기 이북에서 쭉 내려온다고 막 동네 사람들이 돗다리를 싸고 피난을 가겠다고 해서 우리도 나하고 우리가 아버지, 어머니, 누님, 나, 동생들이 남동생 둘, 여동생 둘. 그래서 피난을 가는데 내 나이 10살 때 풀을 짊어지고 걸어서 이제 피난을 가는 거야. 그러면 막 미국에서 노스코리아에서 막 쳐내려오니까 이 유엔군들이 비행기로 막 폭격을 막 하고 피가 오고 뭐 야단 났는데 먹을 식량은 다 떨어졌고 밭에 가서 감자도 캐먹고 또 뭐 별의별 고생을 다 했지. 그 고생은 말도 못했지. 노코리아 사람들이 갑자기 쳐내려온 바람에 정말 무지무지한 고통을 겪어서 이제 6.25가 이제 시작이 됐는데 한참 전쟁하다가 우리 사우스 코리아 군인들이 이제 밀려가고 저 대구까지 밀려갔는데 또 맥아더 장군이 와서 인천 상륙작전을 해서 다시 또 북으로 올라갔어. 북으로 올라가고서 이제 싸우다가 또 중공군이 차이나로 중공군이 또 내려온 바람에 또 밀려 내려왔어. 그러니까 올라갔다 내려왔다. 그러니까 그 군인들이 싸워서 해서 노스로 올라갔다 노스에서 또 내려왔다 또 올라갔다 이럴 적마다 수많은 사람들이 죽었죠. 왜 죽었느냐 하면 전쟁도 전쟁이지만 노스 코리아에서 천일에 오면은 가서 그 인민들을 그냥 무지무지하게 많이 죽였어. 뭐 수도 없이 수십만 명씩 막 죽였다. 그러다가 다시 또 쳐 올라갔다가 또 내려오면 또 죽이고 그 고통은 이루 말할 수가 없지. 그 뭐 유엔군이 아니었으면은 우리 한국은 지금 노스코리아가 됐더라면은 다 굶어 죽고 아마 다 거지가 됐을지도 모르지. 근데 다행히 유엔군이 들어와서 그 노스코리아를 다 무찌르고 휴전을 하고 이래서 지금 오늘날 세계에서 저는 이제 수리 12번, 12번째 경제 국가가 돼갖고 오늘날 대한민국은 너무 잘 사는데 지금 노스코리아는 커반 다 굶어 죽어 지금. 그 저 몇 사람 빼놓고 다 지금 뭐 그 밥을 매일 굶고 애들도 지금 자라질 못해서 먹질 못하니까 너무너무 그 어려운 생활을 하고 있고 유교라고 하면 너무너무 끔찍해. 이놈들이 내려오면은 그 노스코리아 그 군인들이 그냥 사우스코리아 사람들을 막 쏴 죽였으니까 뭐 막 쏴 죽이고 소도 막 끌어서 나 지들이 잠 먹고 쌀 다 뺏어가고 그게 지금 가만히 생각하면 미국이 너무너무 고마운 걸 느끼고 미국이 아니었으면은 우리 대한민국은 지금 웃는 거야. 완전히 거지들만 살고 이 노스코리아 저 딕테러 김정일이가 이제 그냥 혼자 잘 살겠다고 국민들 다 지금 굶어 죽이고 있으니까 정말 미국한테 너무너무 고맙고 유엔들 정말 고맙고 그래서 우리가 지금 많은 그때 우리가 도움을 받은 나라들한테 지금 많이 돕고 있고 또 나부품도 남의 나라 돕는 행렬에 나도 같이 합세해서 그런 행동을 하고 있는데 어쨌든 노스코리아는 너무너무 이 인간이 아닌 인간들이라고 그 커뮤니스트라는 건 커뮤니스트 아니고 그건 완전히 독재국 이 세계에서 이 노스코리아 같은 나라는 어디도 없어. 그건 뭐 상상할 수 없는 그건 미친놈들이라고 봐야 돼. 미친놈들. 그 저 김정일이, 김일성이, 김정은 이놈들은 인간도 아니야. 그런 쥐들만 잘 살자고 다른 놈들을 다 죽어주는데 이건 너무도 있을 수 없는 일이고 6.25 때 너무너무 어려움을 당해서 아주 노스코리아는 이가 가지고 아주 뭐 말을 표현을 못할 정도로 기록이 있었다고.